you see, dear ones, in every moment we are this awareness. And existing within this awareness is a constant changing experience of manifest form. We are the unmanifest consciousness, that which exists but cannot be seen, cannot be pointed to, but which each and every one of us intimately knows. And so, dear ones, our suffering comes through the personal identification with the changing forms of this world. That is the nature, that is the root of the suffering that we experience. For we believe ourselves to be this body. We believe ourselves to be this mind. We believe ourselves to be the content of our mind. You see, dear ones, you are pure consciousness. You are eternally free. But it is a misunderstanding of yourself that causes identification with these changing forms and manifestation. For the deeper part of you knows yourself to be permanent, yet as you identify with the impermanent, forever changing forms of this world, you feel suffering within, for you are limiting that which you truly are. You are only experiencing, only knowing, a very limited part of your eternal self. And then, dear ones, as you live in this world of form, it is because of your identity with the form of your human mind-body system that you then enter into the experience of suffering. For you believe yourself to be your thoughts, you believe yourself to be your personality, and you think that you must uphold this limited structure, you must uphold your self-identity, you must uphold your personality. You think that you must build a better personality, a stronger personality, to be more liked by others, to find a relationship with others, to be more successful in the eyes of others. You judge yourself and try to change your mind-body system based upon your own limited perception of how you see others responding to you. And so you become a slave of your limited perception. And so you become a slave of how you perceive others to be perceiving you. Understand, dear one, that your perception of yourself is limited, and your perception of how others perceive you is far more limited than how you perceive yourself. And, dear ones, it is their perception of you through their own personal ego that is limited. So they cannot see you, and you cannot see them, and yet you believe that you must uphold and create yourself based upon how others perceive you. Can you see, dear one, how much limitation you get entangled within? Can you see how much confusion you enter into in each daily life? Can you, dear ones, understand how you cause your suffering? Can you understand how to be free of this suffering within? You see, dear ones, the suffering that you experience is being created by you. And the key to your own personal happiness is within your reach. It begins, dear ones, by knowing the awareness that you are, by staying in this awareness, and simply allowing the identification that you have formed with your mind, emotions, and body to be released. You surrender your identification with these forms. You let it go. You give it up. And you learn to trust in the universal intelligence that is creating all of life. You learn to trust in God. You learn to surrender your personal will, realizing its limitations, and begin to trust and interact with the greater conscious will of the Creator. You learn to live in harmony with life, rather than subjecting yourself to the confusion that arises through personal identification with manifest form. You see, dear ones, when we talk about spiritual enlightenment, many of you come to this conversation with many beliefs that you have picked up from the minds of others. They have been told that enlightenment is the experience of pure light, and so you believe this when they tell it to you. They have been told that enlightenment will only exist after the body dies, and so you believed this when they have told it to you. And they have been told that enlightenment means leaving this world and entering some higher dimensional state. And you believe this when they told it to you. And so, dear one, many of your beliefs about what spirituality is, about who you are, about what enlightenment is, comes simply from conversations that you have had with others. It is content being exchanged from one mind to another. It is not, dear one, the direct experience of what is. The true path, dear one, of spiritual understanding is having the direct experience yourself. And because the spiritual self is beyond the human mind-body system, any information in the mind cannot give you this experience. It can help you to understand the perception and the experience of others, but content within the mind cannot give you the experience of enlightenment. You must, dear ones, let go of the mind, let go of the security that you have found by identifying with certain beliefs, and you must trust in the greater source of life. You must allow for the unknown to happen. You must allow yourself to transcend your current experience and to enter into an experience beyond that which you have ever known, as directed from the greater consciousness which you are and which all of life is. You see, dear one, the spiritual path requires trust, trusting in the greater intelligence, trusting in a consciousness that you may never fully understand, but that which you fully are. Spirituality, dear ones, is learning to trust in God, learning to surrender your desire for personal control, realizing that control is based upon fear, understanding that you are far more in this human mind and body, understanding that your happiness will only come hand in hand with your own freedom. Freedom from limitation, freedom from suffering, and freedom to feel yourself, to know yourself as one with all of life, pure expansive consciousness, pure expansive awareness, the fullness of love, life, energy, no longer resisting, no longer judging, no longer limiting anything at all. It is living in a state of freedom, being one with life, and discovering your eternal self.